In this video, we're quickly deriving a formula for the derivative of the inverse tangent function, and then we're going to work a quick example where that's combined with the chain rule. So like anything involving inverse functions, the way to get a handle on it is to give a name to that inverse function, so we'll call it y. Y equals tangent inverse, or arctangent, x. So one way of saying that is y is the angle whose tangent is x. So we can turn this equation around and say the tangent of y is equal to x. And now we have a more familiar situation. We just have an ordinary tangent function. What we're going to do next is differentiate both sides with respect to x. And on the left-hand side, we have the x derivative of tangent y. And this requires the chain rule. The tangent of y is the tangent of some function of x. The chain rule says we would differentiate the tangent of y first with respect to y itself. That gives us secant squared of y. But then you have to tack on the derivative of y with respect to x. Now that's sometimes called implicit differentiation, but that's really just the chain rule. On the right-hand side, I have the x derivative of x, which is 1. Now we can solve for dy dx. And I get 1 over secant squared y. Now what we're hoping for is to get a formula for this derivative entirely in terms of x. So we need to substitute back our definition of y. That was the inverse tangent of x. So I get dy dx, the derivative we're looking for, is 1 over secant squared of the inverse tangent of x. In other words, we're going to get the secant of the angle whose tangent is x and then square that. Now this sort of expression can always be reduced to an algebraic expression. I have a trig function of an inverse trig function. The standard way to deal with this is to draw a reference triangle so we can visualize the angle whose tangent is x and then take the secant of it. So we're going to put the inverse tangent of x, the angle whose tangent is x, right here. And remember, we had a name for that. That was just y, so we may as well label it accurately. Well, that's the angle whose tangent is x. That means the opposite over the adjacent side has to be equal to x, and we can just choose those to be x for the opposite side and 1 for the adjacent side. Now, using the Pythagorean theorem, I have 1 squared plus x squared is equal to the hypotenuse squared. And this means the hypotenuse is the square root of 1 plus x squared. If I square 1 and add it to x squared, that's 1 plus x squared. If I square the hypotenuse, I get 1 plus x squared. So that's the correct labeling for the triangle. Now our goal is to get the secant of this angle. So the secant of y, or the secant of the angle whose tangent is x. And secant is 1 over the cosine. Well, the cosine would be adjacent over hypotenuse. The secant is hypotenuse over adjacent. So the secant of the angle whose tangent is x is just the hypotenuse, 1 plus x squared square rooted, over 1. Finally, to get our formula for the first derivative of the inverse tangent, we have to have the square of the secant of the inverse tangent of x in that denominator. When I square this thing, it undoes the square root, and I simply get a 1 plus x squared, or x squared plus 1, in the denominator. So we have our formula for the derivative of an inverse tangent. Let's apply our new formula to find the derivative of the inverse tangent of 2x. So this is just combining our new formula with the chain rule. To differentiate the inverse tangent of 2x, we just take 1 over 1 plus the argument of that function, that's 2x, squared. And then we have to multiply by the derivative of that argument. This is just applying the chain rule. So we have 1 over 1 plus the argument of the inverse tangent function, squared. So 2x all squared is 4x squared. And then we multiply by the derivative of the argument. The derivative of 2x is just 2. We can clean this up a little by writing it as 2 over 1 plus 4x squared. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.